Here I have a Co-Spa's hot tub that's tripping the breaker. Notice there was no power. So let me just turn it back on. It doesn't trip halfway, it just trips off fully. Turn it on. And it trips off after a while. Turn it on. Trips after a few seconds. There you go. Let's figure out why. Once you find the spa pack, there's two screws right here. You just undo them. You don't have to take them out all the way. This is one there, and then one there, and then the door comes off. Now this one here, it says Co-Spa's on an advanced control system, but what it is, it's a Balboa BP501. That's what type of spa pack's in here. So if you're looking for any problems with your tub, like here, it's a Co-Spa, but it's your equipment that you have to look for. So if you're looking for any problems with the BP501, then you search online for the BP501, not just Co-Spa's. Okay, we got the door off. All your information's right in the back of the door right there, if you're looking for anything. So normally what we do is, what's tripping the brake, it's not tripping right away. There's a little bit of a pause there. But normally, we kind of look for the ozonator, and that'd be the first thing. The second thing would be the element. Sometimes you'll have a copper strip on here. You have to undo it from the top of the element. But here we have the style where it clicks right into the board, so it's easy. We just have to unclick it. But for this one, we're going to undo an ozonator if he has it. I'm not sure where it is. So we're going to look on the board. So the power is off. Make sure the power is on. I know it's tripping, but whenever you're working on this stuff, you got to make sure it's off. So there is this is pump two. So we're just going to move that out of the way. So there we go. We disconnected that. So the last thing you want to, like, never unplug everything, then turn the power back on and then plug it in while the power is on. You'll get this arcing. So never, ever do that. Never take them all off first, turn on the power, and then plug them each in. Don't do that at all. So since I got pump two unplugged, I'm just going to keep that unplugged. Well, now we're going to, we'll plug it back in. So make sure pump two goes back in, because I just moved out of the way. So ozonator, try the breaker. So try the breaker and see if it's ozonator. If it stays on, it's the ozonator. If it trips, it's something else. It trips, not the ozonator. So we have to unplug that just to get it out of the way. So pump two, we're going to have that unplugged. Plug your ozonator back in. Okay, so our ozonator is back in. Since we have that unplugged, we're going to try the breaker. So this is for pump two. It's not pump two. Plug that back in. Okay, we're going to try the element right here. It's on the board. So disconnect it from there's a little tab at the top. Yours might be sideways if it's a different pack. But there's a little clip you just push down. So make sure it's not touching anything. We're going to try the breaker again. Now let's try the heater element. If it stays on, then we got to change the heater element. Yeah, I heard a click at the spa pack. So it's a heater element. Now, if you watch any of my other videos, I don't like touching these knife valves right here because they always fail. I always just drain it. But if you feel that you're going to have to turn those knife valves off, go ahead and do it. But I wouldn't recommend it. But if you do, you shut those off and you got to look at the pump. See that pump there? We have to isolate the water. So we want to take that heat tube out. So there's a shut off right here. So you got to shut that off. There, follow this along and then goes that way. There's the shut off valve right there. We got to shut that. But we have an air bleeder hose right here. So you got to pinch that. It's always going to leak because you don't want to pinch it too hard. You want to wreck it. But you got to pinch that so no water comes out. You might have a little bit. So for this hot tub here, I'm going to drain it. I'm going to remove that heat tube and replace that element. Turn the power off. If you have a submersible pump, you can drain it that way. I'm just using a quick drain right now. Drain out to the side, it's a little faster. If you have a drain plug on the corner of your hot tub, never use that. It fails a lot. The more you mess with plastic, just leave it the way it is. Get a quick drain or a submersible pump and then drain your hot tub that way. And just clean the hot tub as it's going down. I'll link right above here how to clean your hot tub. Here comes some fun parts. Sometimes you have the ground in the way because we got to take this off. You got to go towards you on the left. And then that one there, we go towards the tub. And we got all these wires in the way, so you got to make sure we're not going to pinch anything. Because it's this close, this little piece, I'm going to just take out the whole thing. It's just easier when you go to put the heat tube back in. You don't have to mess with it. So inspect everything. These black O-rings, if you do this and your finger is black, you gotta replace it. Right there, you gotta replace that. And you grease it up, put the new one in. I'll link everything down below if you need anything. The heat tube gaskets, same thing. Looks like it's falling apart. Yeah, it's pretty bad shape. So we're gonna replace that. And we're gonna replace that one too. Since you got it all out. So we have our heater disconnected. Now our two sensors, we're gonna disconnect them. Don't touch the connection on the board. We're gonna take them off from here. So everything should be finger tight. Just when you go to take these off, these sensors, and make sure that the O-ring, the black O-ring right here, that's there. Sometimes they come off, they get stuck on the top of that, and then you lose them. So make sure it's still there. And that stays on that side. Pop that off. Black O-ring still there. Move this on this side. Now, the tricky part. There's a bolt back underneath here, right there, and there's one underneath here, right there. Gotta take that off. You don't have to take it fully off, but just so we can move this whole thing right here. So loosen those up. So when you think they're loose enough, pop this off. Yeah, this one's still not high enough. Really stuck on there. So I'll show you how to change this out and put it back in. I'm going to show you super fast how to change this element. We have videos on our channel, you can check it out. I'm just showing you how fast you can change it. I'm not going to edit anything. Now this element has never been changed before. It's the original. Come on now. Now, when you get your element, I'll link everything down below. This one, all information's right on the side. This is a 5.5 kilowatt heater element. So I'll link the 4 and the 5.5 because you might have the 4 kilowatt. So the kit that comes with it when you get it with the element, it'll have new bolts. And they'll have, new nuts. So don't worry about it. You can throw those out. Size that is. It's a 19. Most of my videos, I'll just use a wrench. Pieces flying everywhere. Has this this lock ring or lock washer, it won't be in the kit, so I always keep those. I'm gonna put that back on. Come on now. That's why I was tripping. The corrosion right on the bottom there. There's our new element. This one does have the rings in there, so I'll use that. Anything the brand new stuff is better. Stuff. There's the new stuff. Now on the element you have the O-rings. So what I do is, see, they're gonna fall off. So if I do this, see, they fall off. I don't want it to do that because if we have to flip it around inside when we go to put it on, I don't want this O-ring to maybe go up and it gets pinched all the time. So take a little bit of silicone. Stuff's like thick. I'll link the stuff down below. And I just put some on. One, because it stays on there. Camo now. Stays on. Go. Okay, see, does it fall over, does it move? That's what I want it to do. Push it on. Oop. Like I said, we have a lot of videos with me changing these out. Normally I never, this is the first video where I'm using a socket. That's how I normally do it. Get it up. Come on now. See, you might have to flip it. Oh, what am I doing here? Oh, I'm way off. Gotta go to the next one. There we go. So see, we're gonna flip it. That's why we put a little bit of silicone there. Washer, new nut. Now, when you, it's good to watch one of my other videos. how I do this. There's little tricks. You don't want the element touching the inside of this heat tube at all. So you flip it the other way, put my fingers in there, because I know when I'm gonna, when I'm tightening it, it's gonna wanna do this. And a lot of times when people put them in, they don't do this part. So I'm forcing with my hand, I can feel it, I'm forcing it to keep stay center. It's gonna wanna go this way. And I can push it back with my hand. So now it's just, I can feel it going, turning. So just snug, you don't have to, it's not like you're putting a tire on. So snug as a bug. I don't know if you can see that. Dead center, not touch anything because we got the centers, we got the sensors down the center. A little off. Push it. There we go. Oh, can we see it? Right there. That's it. And we're going to put that back in. Oh, before we go, we're going to put this on. So, yeah, put it exactly the same way. Because we know that it's going to plug in like this. The same way. Come on now. Okay. Our wrench. Keep dropping tools. This bit. Okay. A little tool underneath, so we don't want that element twisting at all. So I gotta hold everything. Bring that back. Okay. There we go. Snug. Next one. Come on now. Again, I'm holding everything. Yeah, move that out of the way. Snug. There we go. Now, for this connection here, you'll see some little bit of grease in there. If you don't have a little bit of grease in those connections, it's not like grease, but it's dielectric grease, and just squirt some in there on each tab and then plug it in. I'll link that stuff down below. Dielectric grease. Now we're ready to put it in.
Put the heat tube back in, just do the opposite of what you did when you took it out. I always recommend to record stuff if you're gonna take stuff off, put it back on. But there it is, it's back together.
Hot tub is full.
Turn the power on. Set your temperature. Make sure there's no airlocks. Airlocks is coming out. It's slightly coming out. What you do is, there's two pumps, so we're gonna hit pump one. So it's on. Let it run for a bit. Okay. There we go. Just before it goes on, then just put down a low speed. There we go, high speed. Pump two. Add your shock. Once it warms up and gets to your set point, that's when you balance your water.